Back to another weekly Australian grocery haul and meal plan. If you are new here, hello and welcome. I am so happy that you clicked on my video today. My name is Katrina, and on this channel I share my family of four's weekly Australian grocery haul and meal plan, and I also like to share what's for dinner videos once a fortnight and also meal prep videos, and I am going to be making some what I eat in a day videos as well. So I'm excited for all that foodie content to come out soon. If you like that kind of content, I would love to have you stick around, hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell notifications on the side to all so that YouTube can notify you every single time that I upload a new video. Now let's get into the meal plan first, and I'm gonna let you know what my family of four are having for dinner this week. So on Monday night we're going to be having butter chicken with rice. On Tuesday night we're having homemade fish cakes with salad. Now this meal is inspired by my friend here on YouTube, Jen Chapin. She has been so amazing to me lately, giving me a shout out on my channel and just chatting to me in general, and I just absolutely love her channel anyway. I've been watching her for years, and I just wanted to make sure that I mentioned that that is where I got that recipe from. Well, actually, I am using a recipe that I found online, but I did definitely get the inspiration to make my own fish cakes from her channel. Then on Wednesday night, we are going to be having ravioli bolognese. On Thursday night, we're going to be having sheet pan sausage and veggies. Friday night, just another easy teriyaki chicken and sheet pan vegetables. On Saturday night, we're going to be having lasagna and salad, just nice and easy, so I don't have to cook really. And then on Sunday night, we're going to be having carbonara tortellini. So now I'm going to go ahead and pick up those groceries, and then I'll be back to show you what we got in our grocery haul. Go ahead, go and catch me, baby. So the first thing I picked up this week was the 2 kilogram beef lasagna for Saturday night, and that's just going to go with some salad, nice and easy. Then we grabbed a 8-pack of sausages here. That is for the sausage and veggie sheet pan recipe that I'm making. Then I've gone ahead and grabbed 2 of these breast fillet packets. I grabbed 1, but they've obviously substituted it for 2 because they didn't have the bigger bulk packet, which is fine because you normally get more that way and it works out cheaper. So I'm happy about that. And that is for a couple recipes that I'm making this week. This is the fish that I decided to go with. It was so hard to decide which one to go with for the fish cakes, but I ended up getting some bassa fillet. So I hope that they taste all right, but they were the only ones that weren't like, that didn't cost an arm and a leg. So I thought I would try those ones out. Then I went ahead and grabbed 2 bags of this ricotta and roasted vegetable tortellini. Again, I grabbed 1 big bag and they substituted that with 2 of the smaller 360 gram bags, so that's fine. And then I grabbed 4 packets of the double garlic bread. This garlic bread brand is the best. It's just the Essentials, Woolworths brand, I'm pretty sure, but it is so much better than the other brands. It's so much cheaper. It's $1.90 for a 2-pack, and we just love this one here. Then I've gone ahead and grabbed this Proactive buttery flavored flora, just for toast and things in the morning. I've changed over from butter to this one just because trying to be a little bit healthier. I've gone ahead and grabbed this sour cream. That's for the butter chicken this week. I cannot eat butter chicken without sour cream on top, but I'm the only one that eats it, so I've just gotten a little tub of that for myself. Then I've grabbed a 2-liter A2 light milk. I grabbed a jar of butter chicken just to make it nice and easy that night, throw together that meal. And then I also grabbed some frozen broccoli and cauliflower for the freezer. That's going in a couple of the sheet pan meals this week. Then I went ahead and treated us all to this packet of Dairy Milk Freddo Milky Top Freddos, and that is because they were in the rewards app that you got bonus points if you brought any of the Dairy Milk Freddos this week. So I went ahead and grabbed a packet for us. I also grabbed this packet of mini M&Ms. I've been loving having these on my ice cream when I have dessert at night, and they just go so well. It just makes me feel like I'm having a McFlurry from McDonald's. So it's kind of like a homemade McFlurry. So that makes me happy, and it saves a ton of money. And I grabbed a new little jar of garlic. This is the Gallico garlic paste. I've never tried this one before. I normally get the Master Foods, but I thought I would give this one a try. Then these Master Foods packet came at 3 for $6 this week. So I grabbed 2 of the carbonara ones. And I also went ahead and grabbed a creamy cheesy potato bake one as well, because we are probably going to be wanting potato bake at some point in the future because we do like that one. So I thought I would grab that just to chuck in the cupboard. I grabbed 2 packets of these strawberry yogurt rice cakes for my younger one, and 2 of these sweet potato, lamb and couscous pouches just for quick, easy lunches. Then I grabbed 2 boxes of the Belvita breakfast chocolate biscuits. They were down to $2 a box this week, so I grabbed 2 of those. Then I grabbed a box of Ritz biscuits. This comes with the 3 packets in there and they just last us a while, so I like to grab those ones. I grabbed a loaf of Low GI white bread. Again, 4th week running, they had this bread. Finally, maybe it won't be an issue anymore, so I'm really happy that I'm just getting this bread all the time now. So that's a massive win in my books. Then I've grabbed 2 tubs of these Caesar salad kits. That's for the lasagna night, and I can't remember why I got the other one, but if it doesn't go with the dinner, then I'm sure I will have it for lunch one day. I grabbed 3 punnets of strawberries. My kids are finally back on fruit again, so I couldn't be happier. They are still liking the smoothies, but they're happy to eat fruit as well on the side of other meals. So I've grabbed 3 punnets of strawberries this week. I've grabbed a big bunch of carrots for a couple meals this week. I've grabbed a bunch of spring onions, couple cucumbers just for snacking on. I got 2 brown onions. They didn't have any frozen onion this week on the, well, they didn't have any on the online app anyway. Sometimes they say they are out of things and then you go into the store and they're there, but I just really didn't want to go into the store tonight, so I went ahead and just brought those ones. And I have a little chopper in my cupboard, like a little vegetable chopper, so I'm gonna give that one a try. A couple of my friends here on YouTube have left a comment saying that I should use the chopper, so I'll give that a try. I haven't used it for onions yet, so we'll see how that goes. Hopefully it's a little less painful on my eyes. Then I've grabbed a massive amount of bananas. Again, I'm just going to be freezing a bunch of those for smoothies, and then a bunch of them is just for eating for my kids to eat. My 3-year-old absolutely loves bananas, so they will be gone before the end of the week for sure. Then I've grabbed 2 massive sweet potatoes. Just going to chop those up and chuck them in the freezer just to have them meal prepped for whenever I feel like throwing them onto a sheet pan veggie meal. I've grabbed a whole bunch of yogurts this week. So I've just grabbed 4 of these, sorry, 3 of these banana boost immunity Valia probiotic yogurts, and then I've got 3 of the strawberry ones. I've got 4 of the mini Bluey custards. That's just a nice treat for them. They love it because Bluey's on it, so you have to pay the extra price, but they love it, so it's worth it. I've grabbed a couple of these sour cream and chive potato mashes that I rave about all the time. They were on special and I just had to grab some more. I always like to have these stocked up because I really don't like to eat my mashed potato without it. Then I've also grabbed 3 of these dairy-free coconut yogurts for my younger one. I really needed to stock up on some brown sugar. We have run out of a lot of our baking supplies, so I thought I would grab this week. This is the one that we seem to be needing the most, so I grabbed that one. And I got 2 tins of this Carnation light and creamy evaporated milk. One of my friends here, or subscribers here, commented down below on one of my videos and told me to try out the evaporated milk instead of cream in the recipes that call for cream, because this one is 95% less fat than cream. And to be honest, I could not tell the difference at all between this and cream. And it just makes me so happy when I find healthy alternatives to recipes or things that I can add that are hidden and things like that. So this just makes me really happy. It tastes almost the exact same. I wouldn't say there's any difference that I've noticed yet for the recipes that I've used it in anyway. So if you are someone that uses cream a lot in your recipes, go ahead and try this one out and see how you go. I really don't think that there is much of a difference. So I'm really loving that substitute at the moment. And last but not least, I just went ahead and got some of these Total Care little floss sticks. These are in the mint flavor. I've never had flavored ones of these. I normally just go to the Reject Shop, which is like a $2 store here, and I just grab a whole bunch of these. They come in like a pack of 100, but I grabbed these in the mint flavor just to try them out. Okay friends, so that is everything that is in this week's grocery haul and meal plan. If you haven't already, go ahead and pause this video and take a guess at how much you think these groceries for my family of 4 cost us behind me. And if you have already taken that guess, I'm gonna go ahead and let you know what the price of these groceries were this week. So they were $193.82, except I did get a refund of $9. So if you guessed around 190, then you were spot on. Thanks so much for playing along, and I hope you all enjoyed this week's weekly Australian grocery haul and meal plan. If you did, be sure to give it a huge thumbs up. And also, if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe down below and turn on those bell notifications to all so that you do not miss any of my future grocery hauls and what's for dinner videos, because there are plenty of new dinner ideas coming up on my channel. It was so good to see you all again this week. Can't wait to chat to you all in the comments below, and I will see you all again really soon. Bye. Turn it up, turn it up.